We're going back in time, counting down the top 80 songs from the greatest pop music decade in the history of human civilization, the 1980s. You're listening to the 80 of the 80s podcast with your hosts, DJ CK1 and AK47.
How should we start episodes?
I think with a greeting.
A greeting?
Isn't that the proper way to
That's
do it?
That's just kind of cliche. I think we need to liven it up a little bit. I think we should start it by mentioning the distinctive keyboard riff that's in each of these 80 songs. Because most of these 80 songs have a very distinct keyboard riff. What are you doing?
I'm just moving the chair so I
Why?
Can... So I can put my foot on it. Why do you have to ask me about everything I do?
Okay. Well, I mean, again, I just don't want to ruin the integrity of the show with background noises that might distract our listeners.
And taking 30 seconds to ask me this and explain it is not distracting.
Sacrifice 30 seconds for 14 and a half minutes without chair noises, I think, is worthwhile.
Okay. Continue, please.
Yes. No chair noises on this show. Okay. No! Stop. Stop.
Okay.
So anyway, I think the keyboard riff to the song after the proclamation of Dead Giveaway is... Doesn't that sound like kind of like it's a news flash? Like, news flash! Dead Giveaway!
It's like the old MTV News thing. They don't even do that anymore,
no,
do they?
No, MTV News, they did, Megadeth.
That's right.
They did the Megadeth song, and then they had the Staples.
Yes.
No, actually, I'm sorry.
It was a typewriter.
That was the beginning, was the Staples, and the end was the...
Typewriter? Wasn't there like a typewriter?
That was at the beginning. I said Staples. Typewriter. One of those office machines, you know? Yeah.
There's a big difference between a typewriter.
For you kids these days, let's explain what a typewriter is.
And do they not know what a stapler is either?
Forgot. Well,
they probably staple with their minds.
They do.
No.
Like an e-stapler?
That's right.
Or an i-stapler?
Okay.
They merge documents together with virtual staples.
Okay. Paperclips.
All right. Well, anyway, let's get on with... Well, shoot. I forgot the secret word. We always have to start with... Wait. Let's do a greeting. How about that? That's a good idea. You want to start with a greeting.
Now you like my idea. Okay.
Actually, we started with some random aside that people weren't expecting. Now we'll go to the greeting. And the greeting is, my name is DJ CK1, suckas.
Suckas. I've never heard you say that.
Well, I'm saying it now.
Okay, well, I'm AK-47.
Because I'm a disc jockey, and disc jockeys say words like that.
You're a dick jockey?
Disc.
Sorry.
Let's move on. Secret word of today. Let's press the button.
Okay.
Will you press the button this time?
I will press the button,
I'm having butterfingers tonight.
It would be my honor.
Okay, since you press the button, I get to read the secret word, and the secret word is a verb. I don't know if we've had a verb before. I don't think we have. We've had nouns and we've had adjectives. Mm-hmm. This verb is move.
Yeah.
So for the rest of the podcast, if anyone says move, scream real loud. Instead of testing out the secret word, let's just move on with the song.
Agreed.
Dead Giveaway. Number 74, as chosen by the board and compiled by the Gobotron 2000. Dead Giveaway by the trio of Shalimar. Throughout their many incarnations, Shalimar always has to have three members. I don't know what Shalimar means.
I don't either.
I don't know. It sounds cool, though.
Yeah.
It's smooth.
Smooth.
Kudos to whoever chose the name of the band. Maybe, I don't think you have much of an opinion about this song,
judging from
our pre-show conversations.
Yeah, I don't really know a lot about Shalimar. The song, it's a good song. I wouldn't say that I love it necessarily, so I'm afraid my input in this is just going to be kind of minimal.
Shalimar, they start out very funk and disco, and then move on to like maybe some soul pop.
Thank you.
this album, 1983, The Look, they took more of a synth direction, more of a new wave direction, added more guitars. Maybe, perhaps, that had to do something with Michael Jackson's Beat It. I think that song was very influential in that it became standard to have guitar solos during the bridge of many songs. Maybe they thought, because Shalimar was more popular on black radio stations, because back then you had more segregated music stations. You had the black stations, you had the white stations, and maybe they thought it would help them cross over. They were very popular in England, though. And I don't know if England has much of segregated radio like we did in the States at the time. These are all conjectures as to why they changed their style, but I like it. I like the style of this album, and particularly this song. I like the heavy beats. I like the synth bass. I like the plucking guitars. I'm not as crazy about the guitar solo. What did you think about the guitar solo on this song?
I've heard better.
Yeah. The guitar solo was performed by the guitarist of the time. His name is not coming to me. He's like a guest. This is kind of there, and I think it's probably like maybe the weakest part of the song. Yeah, I think the song does drag on a little long. I don't think it should be really a 5-minute song.
Is it 5 minutes?
It is.
Wow, that is long.
Well, it has, because it has verse, chorus, then it goes into the bridge. And you typically, after the bridge, you're going to have another chorus, but they throw in the third verse. I don't really think the third verse adds much thematically to the song either. The song, it's a little vague, the theme. What do you think about the meaning of the song?
It's confusing. I kind of took it to be that there was some chick using him, but at the same time he's saying, you're a dead giveaway, so why would he let someone that's a dead giveaway use him? So it doesn't make any sense to me.
Right, because in the verses, it sounds like he's saying that she's being deceptive and in disguise, and yet that's kind of the opposite of the meaning of a dead giveaway, because a dead giveaway is, like, obvious.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Or maybe he's just, maybe it's like, hey, I busted you, it's a dead giveaway.
Now she is.
Like, now you're a dead giveaway.
Now she is.
I busted you, now it's a dead giveaway. So I don't know.
Well, in the video, though, it implies that it's this lady in a mask, and he's chasing her all around. And it's revealed to us that she's, Jodie Watley is the lady in the mask. Your favorite lady, huh?
Yeah, I like her. Yeah.
Why? What is it about the mystique of Jodie Watley?
I get a really badass vibe from her. I just like her.
Her sparkly outfits?
Her sparkly outfits. I don't know. I just like her.
I think a bigger badass is Jeffrey Daniels. Because, I mean, what could be more badassery than the man who taught Michael Jackson how to do the moonwalk?
Indeed, you are right.
The man who choreographed, not only Bad, which was pretty badass, but Smooth Criminal, the man who choreographed Smooth Criminal.
Yeah.
I think that's like the highest of badassery. You can't go beyond that.
But no, you're right. Smooth Criminal, that's just brilliant. I mean, when I was a child and I saw that video, I thought about it for weeks afterwards.
You thought about The Lean.
Yes, The Lean. Everybody talked about The Lean. That's so amazing. And now I know how they did it. But at the time, I just thought they were really talented. I don't know.
How did they do it?
Weren't they hooked up to something that held their feet still?
Oh, so it wasn't real? Well, see, I think if it was Jeffrey Daniels, it would have been a real lean.
Oh, of course.
But they thought, we can't do this like Jeffrey Daniels did it. So, you know.
We don't want to injure Michael Jackson.
The moonwalk was a dance that the kids were doing on the streets. And Michael came along later, and he had a guy by the name of Jeffrey Daniels to teach him to do the moonwalk. And Jeffrey taught him to do the moonwalk, and he was good at it. And when he did it, everybody saw it and just thought this was the most wonderful thing they had ever seen, not really knowing it was a dance that was already out there.
The backslide is actually supposed to be like if you were to be walking forward, and suddenly you're on an escalator, and as you're walking forward, this escalator is now pulling you backwards as you're continuing to walk forward. That's the illusion of the backslide. Michael called it the moonwalk, which actually, the moonwalk is another dance. The moonwalk is actually a dance that we do that makes it look like you're on the moon and it's less gravity than you would have on Earth. Michael somehow called the backslide the moonwalk. And commercially, I think maybe it worked.
Oh, we've been through this so many times that it results always the same.
really talking about the song anymore.
So we're talking about picking now.
Yeah, this is really going way off.
No, but that's the beauty of these songs. They're so complex. They take us in so many directions.
Okay.
Jody Watley, she had a small role in this song. She mostly would just say the phrase, "Dad giveaway," in the background. And if you watch the video, it seems like she's kind of phoning it in. She doesn't seem too enthused, and actually right after this video, she left the group. After this video was recorded, Jeffrey Daniels left the group as well.
They switched members a lot, though, didn't
they? They did. Yeah, they did have, and the last incarnation was horrible. Remember that video for Games?
Yeah, I do.
Wasn't that like the worst thing ever?
No, that fancy video was still the worst thing I've ever seen.
The fancy video?
With that Joe Rizzo or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay.
That was the worst thing I've ever seen.
Right. I think if anyone wanted to make a case that the 80s suck, which of course it doesn't, I can't even believe I would say something like that. But, you know, every decade has its embarrassing moments, and it's all kind of summed up with the Shalimar song, Games. We're bringing out the best in the worst. Going back on Jody Watley, she's a fashionable lady. I'm trying to bring you. Come on, let's talk more.
I've told you in the beginning I don't really have a whole lot to say about Shalimar. Because I don't really.
We'll talk about her dress.
I don't really know much about her. I know that she had a see-through sparkly outfit that she wore in like three different videos.
It wasn't see-through.
Well, the top of it was. The glitter just placed right in the right spot. No, she's fashionable. Yeah, I like her.
So her hit song, you like her songs that she had in the 80s that sound just the same?
They sound identical, yeah.
Yeah, I'm Looking for New Love and then Real Love, which are pretty much the same song.
They're pretty much the same song, and I'll have to just combine them into one song and say that, yeah, it's pretty good. I just remember her having these really huge hoop earrings. See, my comments are pointless.
No, it means something. Look.
What does that mean?
I've checked the demographic, and we need more female listeners. So I'm trying to bring out the fashion. And you know what? We haven't even talked about the Shalimar, A Night to the Remember video.
Or the fact that they originated on Soul Train, right?
Right, yes. Jeffrey Daniels, Jody Watley were Soul Train dancers, and they were recruited into the group. The video for A Night to Remember, I wanted to discuss it because do you think there was an implication that there was something going on between Jody Watley, Howie Hewitt, and Jeffrey Daniels in that hotel room? All
of
three of them.
Of course. I mean, it was either some wicked threesome or some bellhop coming in asking if he could screw this guy's wife. I mean, that's pretty freaky.
Howie Hewitt just went right along with it. They made it a night to remember. I think if we invited the bellhop into our hotel room like that and he started dancing with you and started jumping on the bed, I think that would be a night to remember.
That would be definitely.
Maybe not a night to recall to our friends and acquaintances, but it would be memorable.
Definitely.
For the right or wrong, most likely the wrong reasons.
For you.
For me, the wrong
reasons. I'm just kidding.
I'm just kidding.
Okay, moving on.
To our viewer mail. Yes, this is a new segment. Are you excited?
I'm thrilled.
We have a new segment to the show because we have received an email about our show. If you would like to send us email, 80 of the 80s at gmail.com, or you can post a message on Facebook or on YouTube. Hey, we're on iTunes as well now. So check, we're on iTunes,
we're
folks.
We're official.
Yes, we're hitting it big time. Okay. I need to first say this was in regard to our previous podcast, number 76, which was Wham! Everything She Wants. This was the comment he made about this episode. I enjoy this one a lot. Everything She Wants is a good song. Great production. The synth line is really good. I do like what? What? I'll keep going. I do like the version with the extra bridge. How could you settle for a boy like me when all I could see was the end of the week? Yeah, see, we agreed with that too. We liked that part of the song. Okay. But my favorite Wham! Song is Careless Whisper. It's a great song with great imagery. It's nostalgic, new romantic, well-written, and well-executed. I will argue, this is me again, DJ CK1. I would argue it's not really new romantic. I say it's maybe romantic, but I don't think it really fits into the new romantic subgenre. But I'm being a snob about it there. So,
okay. Typical.
Yeah. Wham! Reminds me of J-pop a lot, which I know you love J-pop.
No.
Okay.
No.
I can go for some J-pop. But anyway, okay. Reminds me of J-pop a lot. And that they're fearlessly and apologetically cheesy, catchy, and manufactured for their popularity. It's pretty entertaining and enjoyable if you let yourself not worry about liking this stuff because it's cool or something. I was once riding in a car listening to The Luxury Gap by Heaven 17 and apologizing to my friends about how cheesy it is. But she encouraged me to just like what I like. It really freed me up. Now I think that songs like Temptation are incredible songs. Forget the cheese. It's a great song musically and in about every possible way. I agree.
I think a little cheese is great. You should never be embarrassed of
good.
Anything
yeah.
that you like.
Yeah,
really.
I think happiness is a legitimate emotion.
Yeah.
And it's a good emotion. So if a song makes you happy, go with it and don't care what other people think.
I mean, I still listen to The Greatest Adventure from the Hobbit soundtrack from years ago.
Well, that's not cheesy, though. That's
but
just,
some people may argue
awesomeness.
That it's weird.
Guilt is for Catholics. There's no such thing as a guilty pleasure, folks. There's just pleasure. Just nothing but pleasure. And we've had a pleasurable podcast, I think, folks.
Yeah.
Something else to ponder until number 74.
This is 74, isn't it?
No, this is 75.
In the beginning, you said number 75.
I did? Oops. Okay, folks, this is number 75.
Oh, 75. My gosh.
Next week is 74. And in 74, what is it going to be? I don't know. It should be a surprise. It's whatever the board comes up with. Whatever the Gobotron reveals. We're counting down the greatest 80 songs of the 80s.
All right, get a move on.
Get a move on. Make that move. Yeah. That's another. That's
oh,
another
yeah.
Shawmer hit.
We could go
make
on
that
for
move.
Hours. Make that move right now, baby. Make that move right now, baby. Seriously.
Yes. Who would think that Shalimar would be like an endless well from which conversation was flowing?
Yeah.
Who would have think? Okay.
You rocked, Jody Watley.
Jeffrey Daniels are cool.
Jody Watley.
Jeffrey Daniels. I feel bad for Howard Hewitt.
Howard Hewitt.
He doesn't get any love. Howie.
Wait, what about the other guys that were part of Shalimar?
Who cares about guys? Them? We don't care about the other eras.
Yeah. Suck it.
Suck what?
Thanks for listening to the 80 of the 80s podcast. Questions? Comments? Email us at 80of the 80s, that's 80of the 80s at gmail.com. Like us on Facebook or subscribe to our YouTube channel. That name again, 80of the 80s. Until the next song, this is AK-47 thanking you for your power play. DJ CK1 is in the bathroom. That sound, do you hear it? Is it a dead giveaway as to what he's doing?